Ellen Nechman of Agora Financial joins us now for the Trader Rundown. Another soft start to the week.
Summer days, D-A-Z-E. So it's gotten kind of quiet. Friday was eerily quiet. I think people were on holiday doing whatever they do in the middle of summertime. Same kind of thing Monday, even though we're getting a lot of noise in the news.
So much is happening right now under
not,
the surface.
Not impacting the price, though. So you saw stocks last week. We had a mixed market last week, but we made new highs in tech four sessions in a row. But the big thing I saw last week was the dollar. The dollar made new 2018 highs and had a lower weekly close. So that could be the start of something good for all stocks and all commodities.
Right, so now we have Google earnings coming into the market, so digesting those.
Right.
But we have some more FANG names to go this week.
Right, a lot of tech names are going to be out this week, but earnings have been fantastic for this quarter, as they were last quarter, as they were before that. So nothing's changed as much as things around us seem like they're different.
There's a lot happening.
The market keeps this momentum movement going.
So what do you think about a trade here?
Well, looking at the markets, I remain very positive. I'm still looking at some oil stocks. We had a bit of a pullback in oil once again. After we got up to 75, we gave back about half of those gains. Petrobrazil, a combination of the weakening dollar and oil comeback. So it's broken out. It had been basing out around the $9 per share after falling from 17. So I'm thinking in the long term, Petrobrazil, I'm a big fan of petrol, and I'm a big fan of Brazil.
Would you do an option strategy on this
one? So I would probably look at an option to play it longer term. I'd probably buy the $8 or $9 call, something deep in the money, and buy at least January, but have some time. But I'm thinking crude. It was interesting yesterday that we did not get any sustained positive reaction with all of that Iran bluster.
Right.
Usually, you think about it, 5-10 years ago, that would have been a $3 or $4 move in crude, and that didn't happen.
The market just shrugged it off.
Another 48-hour rule. You got to wait 48 hours to see what it really means. Let the market digest it.
Thanks so much for coming on the show, and have a great trading day, Alan.
Thank you.
Check out businessfirstam.com to find out where to see our entire show. And don't forget to like, follow, and share Business First AM.